Hello and welcome, RoboNation fans, to the start of the biggest and most exciting new autonomous vehicle competition, the Maritime RobotX Challenge.
Having its inaugural year here in spectacular Marina Bay, Singapore, this competition is so huge that we've had to call in a double helping of RoboNation hosts to bring you all the action.
Amy Elliott,
Zaz Brooks,
Grace Chia,
Christine Daly.
We'll be here all week long to keep you up to date with daily recaps and spotlight videos, all leading up to our signature live finals webcast.
This event is so massive that it had to be assembled by an A-list of sponsors.
Their generosity has made it possible for three teams from each of five countries to be given an innovative WAM V catamaran and the chance to bring it out here to compete on an autonomous challenge course for national glory.
The Maritime Robotics Challenge is the first opportunity for Pacific Rim countries to come together, take the best students from five countries, give them a platform that's all the same, and require them to then try to come up with all of the other pieces of this unmanned surface vehicle, this robot that's going to perform some very complicated tasks in the water.
Local organizers, Singapore and the United States, the Office of Naval Research, decided to create a competition in the Pacific Rim. And we went to each of the nations that we invited, Japan, South Korea, and Australia, and asked them to form organizing committees. And then just as in the Olympics, each of the organizing committees in country decided which teams would represent their country's best.
It allows students to focus right on the specific things of sensors, how to adapt to the environment, and understanding how to control a vehicle autonomously. The platform was designed and provided to them, and then everything else was on their own. So it really allowed them to focus into the autonomous systems that's really the focus of this event.
So far, they've been unpacking, assembling, and getting ready for practice. They'll sorely need to excel in these challenges.
This is by far the largest in both size and the magnitude of everything that we've done. Working in a classroom and getting your knowledge in theory is all well and great, but until you've had the hands-on experience on projects like this, you really have not completed your education.
This is our first year joining the competition, so there are many, many parts to be improved. So we try to learn from the competition and try to improve ourselves.
Being a part of the inaugural event was really a big honor, and it's also a great opportunity for research, both undergraduate, graduate work. Because of the scale of the vessel and because of the hours that are going to be committed to it, it made sense to turn it into a research platform for our universities.
We expect to learn a lot. We expect to collect a lot of data that we haven't been able to collect before because we don't have all of the obstacles at home, and hopefully adapt our system to deal with that.
I chose this competition because my research area is somewhat related to autonomous and control stuff, and I'm in the Department of Naval Architecture and Ocean Engineering, so this is a perfect combination for my case.
I think it would be like a great opportunity for us, not just for me, but for the whole people who are in our laboratory. I think the first time that you're dealing with this size of robot, and it has like different knowledge, different things that you can learn with that. So I think it would be like a great experience.
They've got their work cut out for them, so it promises to be an exciting week.
And we're gonna be here with you all the way to keep you informed as it unfolds. Stay tuned for all the highlights of qualifying and then our live finals webcast this Sunday, starting at 11 a.m. Singapore time. That's 11 p.m. Eastern or 8 p.m. Pacific for those in the United States, here at robotx.org.